is a Gyropyra green tree python.
Mm-hmm.
And the name Gyropyra is the locale it's from, like where it originated from.
Uh-huh.
The care on these is, you know, for a substrate I use cypress mulch. You can get at Home Depot for like $2.70 a bag.
Uh-huh.
And I make sure there's like, you know, a vine so he can climb up to get onto his perch, which is PVC pipe.
Now, do they require a lot of humidity?
They require like 80-100% humidity, so you gotta spray them at least 3 times a day.
Uh-huh.
You know, maybe you can get away with 2.
Wish he'd show us his head.
And they usually
don't... Oh, the glass can't be opened. Okay, you got it. He's got a lock on there, so he can't maybe get out.
Yeah, it's very important to have a lock-proof cage because snakes are escape artists.
Now, let me ask you something. How often do you need to feed him?
Just one rodent a week.
Okay.
Usually, you know, determine the size by the size of the head of the snake.
Storm and I, we did the perch. It's actually, we got the ends, like over here at Walmart. And what they are, they're shower curtain rod holders. And then we got a piece of PVC pipe, because then we can bleach it and keep it cleaned out. Okay, what do you want to show us next?
This is...
What do we got in here? Oh, yeah.
This is a giant Madagascar day gecko.
Yeah, you see, I'm sorry for the water spots, guys, but he's got to keep him really humid. Let me see if I can get down here and get away from the... it's kind of hard. Yeah, it's kind of spotty. But he got this guy because he only has 3 legs.
And he actually is supposed to look a little bit brighter, but usually they change color kind of. But it's a gecko you never hold because their skin rips like a butterfly.
Really? It's kind of hard to see
them. They eat baby food like mango or applesauce.
Uh-huh.
And the substrate I use for that is Ecorth because it's made out of coconut husk.
Mm-hmm.
It looks like a soil, but what's cool about it, if they do eat it, it goes mm-hmm. right through their system.
Now,
calcium sand and...
And then the next thing we have is something Storm rescued from somebody. And what do we have here, Storm?
This is a Savannah monitor.
Mm-hmm.
It's a male. Obviously, I need a bigger cage.
Right.
Which I just ordered. I'm going to order it tonight. A 4x2x2.
Mm-hmm.
And temperament, they're pretty docile. They're very hardy. You know, they have like a lot of heat, but not so much heat that someone burned him with.
Oh, so somebody burned him. Is he going to be okay?
Yeah, he'll be okay. Actually, it just scarred up. It was a big scab before.
Mm-hmm.
And
now he's shedding, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Usually you want to give him a bowl that they can soak the whole body in, but until I get the bigger cage,
mm-hmm.
he's kind of had to deal with that.
And then this guy's on cypress mulch, too?
Cypress mulch. They love to dig.
What do they eat?
They eat, this one eats about 3 small rats a week.
Mm-hmm.
And then the other days I feed them ground turkey breasts, but I feed it raw.
Mm, he's sleeping.
And I'll put a calcium D powder on it too.
Look at him sleep.
Yeah, he loves to sleep.
He looks like a big pancake. He's really fat. Okay, so now.
This.
Oh, what do we have over here?
Chilean rosehair tarantula.
Oh, okay.
It's kind of like having a pet rock. Because these guys don't move at all unless they're fed.
And you feed them what, crickets?
Crickets, like 1 or 2 crickets a week. Sometimes mm-hmm. they will actually fast.
Really?
And this species is known for that because they come from a very dry, kind of chilly region.
Mm-hmm. What do we got here?
This is the Antilles pink-toed tarantula. You got a light so you can see her.
Okay, where is it? So I got to look through here. Okay.
No, you can see on the other side. Look.
Mm-hmm. I don't really see pink, but I believe you. I guess we need to do it another day. And they just get what, crickets?
Crickets. That one, both of them I have Eco-Earth on.
Uh-huh.
This one, I have it on Eco-Earth. I
mm-hmm.
spray her like once or twice a day, and she makes a big web she hides in.
Okay, and then what do we have over here?
This one is a very, very hard snake to keep. It's
mm-hmm.
a subadult female emerald tree boa.
Mm-hmm.
And they're known for their nasty bite because they eat birds in the wild. This one's not yet full grown. Same with the green tree python. They're not full grown. They're juvenile.
A picture of his head. I mm-hmm. see.
He puts his head in his little coils.
See his little head there? Let me bend down, see if I can get a better. Oh, no, he's hiding his head, see? I guess he doesn't want to be a star.
You know, they're similar to the other snake, the green tree, by the way they perch up. But the difference is the green tree is a python. The emerald is a boa.
And then the same kind of substrate.
Cypress mulch.
And you spray them too?
Same humidity. For heat for both of them, I use just a 40-watt bulb.
What are you going to show us next, Storm?
You know, what I'm going to show you next is a yellow millennius monitor.
Okay. And are you going to get him out?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Okay, let's see what we got over here, guys. Never a dull moment living with Storm.
I'm actually moving this guy into the Savannah monitor's cage when I get the bigger cage shipped.
Oh, he's pretty.
Yeah, a prehensile tail.
I can't see. Let me turn around.
They like trees. They climb. They walk. I mean, they do. They're pretty much found anywhere. They love to swim. They love water.
Quit moving your hand.
They love a lot of humidity.
Now, how big is he going to get?
3 or 4 feet.
Oh, most of it's, wonderful.
Most of its tail, though.
Most of its tail. Okay.
This one, I have no clue if it's a male or female.
Uh-huh.
I didn't really care about the sex. Females get smaller than males.
And
prettier.
What do they eat?
Right now, she's eating crickets.
Uh-huh.
Same with the ground turkey.
Mm-hmm.
I do crickets 3 days, ground turkey 3 other days.
Mm-hmm.
And then with this one, usually, you know, they're very quick, so you kind of got to watch. She just ate a lot, so she's full.
Mm-hmm. Remember, I'm filming. When you move your hand, I get him out of frame. Okay, so what are we going to see next, Stormy?
The next one is the Colombian red-tailed boa.
Okay.
Now for the yellow millennius monitor, I use newspaper, but that's just till I put her in the bigger 40-gallon tank.
Here, let's get a better look of her.
She likes to hide under the newspaper, I've noticed.
There you go. There's a better picture of her, guys. Let's see here. There you go. Okay, and so who's next?
The Colombian red-tailed boa.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, they come from Colombia.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a female. She'll get about 9 to 10 feet.
Wonderful.
Yeah, my mom loves big reptiles.
Yeah, you gotta pick your battles when you got kids, I guess.
She has a nice saddle, nice, you know, you can see the red, where they get the red tail from.
You keep moving her, and I can't keep her in frame. So her tail's more red. Oh, yeah, that is pretty.
They got prettier ones. This is a regular. They got salmon ones where they're bright pink.
Really?
Now, males get a lot smaller than female Colombian red tails. Males only get 3 feet.
Really?
That's weird. This one always looks like she's going to strike, but she never does.
And now how old is this one?
Probably like a few weeks.
Really?
It's a baby.
And then this eats what, mice or?
She eats I have her, she ate a hopper. She ate a mouse.
What's a hopper?
Hopper's a type of rat, like a size rat.
Okay.
From what I heard from the breeder of this, he recommends rats over mice because they have more nutrients.
Huh.
I don't really know if it's true or not, but...
And then does this one require, I'm looking at the cage, does this one require a lot of humidity?
Not as much humidity as most snakes, you know. But, I mean, just spray her hide box where it's nice and damp.
Mm-hmm. Cool.
And for these guys, I use a heat pad.
Okay, and then that goes under the tank?
Under the tank. Not too hot, but you can determine how hot it is by how much substrate you add.
Mm-hmm. And then you have like a little hide box there.
Yeah, that I moisten.
Okay. What's in that other cage over here? Are we going to see that today or not?
No.
What is it? Oh, yeah. That one's sleeping. Here we go.
This is the green iguana.
Yeah, I got to fix the green iguana's cage for outside.
He made a hole.
He made a hole, so I got to sew it up tonight. And then Storm's having a cage built so he can stay out all the time. He's beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's a pretty guy. He's really pretty. Very, very pretty.
Now this guy will be about 6-7 feet, which I'm pretty sure my mom loves.
Yeah, I know. All these big things, huh? Yeah, he's really pretty. Yeah, I gotta fix his cage.
Yeah,
he's got a hole in it.
Container.
And we kept finding him in the pool swimming.
And for this guy, I use on this. I have a mesh cage I use.
Mm-hmm.
I have a vine in it.
All right.
I use freezer wrap because, you know, it's easy. It's easy to clean. You can see where it craps.
See, for me, move. My favorite out of all these is this guy. And, you know, it's kind of sad. There's this really cool book if you have little kids. It's called Verdi. And it's about a snake like this that didn't fit in. The thing that's cool about these snakes is they, when they're born, they're like bright yellow. And then they slowly change to this gorgeous green. And we had a baby, and it went from the yellow to the green, which is really fascinating. And
she's a juvenile female, so she'll get a lot bigger.
We lost it, and it was basically my fault. I didn't miss the snake enough when Storm got hit by the car. But, you know, you live and learn. But yeah, this, I think out of all of them, this is my favorite. And I love the blue stripe on the back. I think it's the most colorful snakes. This, the camera, I don't think, is really giving you as beautiful as they are. But, well, Storm, I thank you for today.
We got a leopard gecko.
Oh yeah, we have a leopard gecko too.
Yep. She's in here. In a 10-gallon where the yellow Millennius Mudder is, but it's like in cages in this big palace of a container.
Oh, is this where she is?
Yep.
Wow, she's in a palace. And how long? This is Roxanne, and this was the first reptile he got when we moved down to Florida, which was like in 99. So how old is Roxanne now?
Ancient.
Because she was pretty old when we bought her, right?
Yeah, and I know she laid a lot of eggs for them and made babies.
Mm-hmm. She eats crickets.
Crickets, loves superworms.
Uh-huh.
I've heard of people feeding them pinkies. I don't recommend it. It's just wrong.
Yeah. Well, I thank you for your tour today, Storm.
No problem.
Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Sarasota Sunsets. And we'll be posting a new video every day. You're going to break that one down. Thank you again for watching. Bye now. Are you going to make